أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ
فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ
الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمداً عبده ورسوله My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalaamu Alaiykum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. I welcome you once again to Colorado Muslims Fiqh Council. The show, Yas'alunaka, they ask you. Brothers and sisters in Islam, we received a question from the UK, Sister Israt Farhana. She's asking a question on behalf of another sister. A heartbreaking story, and she's really asking an advice from the council on what she should do. Basically, she got married through an arranged marriage. That marriage lasted only 11 months, and she ended up with a son, a boy, who is 2 years old now. So she was divorced after 11 months from the marriage. And basically, she discovered that her husband married her just to please the parents, and he actually said to her straightforward that I married you just to serve my parents. And the reason why he said that to her, of course, I have no way to verify the other side, and I'm just basing this on the email we got from the sister. On behalf of the other sister, that he had a girlfriend and she left him, and that's why he decided to go ahead and marry. So she's asking an advice from the Fiqh Council in Colorado, what she should do. Should she marry or remarry, or should she just stay single and take care of her son and help him grow up. Alhamdulillah, she is saying about the sister that she is a hijabi sister, niqabi sister. Mashallah, she is observing the etiquettes of the Quran and the Sunnah, and she is asking the opinion of the council just for the sake of knowing how to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. First of all, brothers and sisters in Islam, there is a misconception out there in our societies, especially the Muslim communities, that a woman who is divorced or a woman who is a widow, especially if they have children, they shouldn't marry, and this is wrong. Because if you promote this, you're making haram something that is halal. Now, it should be left to the discretion and the judgment of the sister herself. And that particular judgment falls into a very important area. And that area can be addressed through the following question. What is the ruling regarding marriage? Do we have to marry? We know that marriage is the sunnah of the prophets, and it's something that corresponds to our fitra, to our making. We know that. But does a person, whether they are married, whether they are single, or whether they are widowed or divorced and they want to remarry, do they have to marry? That's the question. The answer, yes, if there is too much fitna in being single, in being a widow without a husband, or being a divorced without a husband. If the sister can handle staying without a man, without being exposed to fitna, it is permissible for her not to marry. But if there is fitna, she has to look for a husband, and she has to simply find out a way where she can get married. But she has to be very careful regarding the choice of a man, the choice she will make about that future husband. Why? Because of her son. She has to be extremely careful, and she has to make sure that this man can be a good father for her child. She should not rush into that decision. If she can handle it without marriage, then we say it's highly recommended that she get married for the sake of finding somebody who can help her son grow up and so forth. But it is haram, brothers and sisters in Islam, to make the lawful unlawful because of societal norms, especially if there is consequences upon the individual if he or she adheres to these societal norms, which has nothing to do with the religion of Islam at all. I'm talking about the culture which is out there, that a woman who is divorced with children or a woman who is widowed with children are not to marry again. This is a cultural practice. This is a societal norms. They can marry, and this is fine, absolutely fine. As a matter of fact, it is mandatory if there is too much fitna on them. But again, an advice, my dear respected sister, please pass it on to your sister in Islam. Be careful and take your time choosing your future spouse if you choose to take that route, because the consequences is not only going to be on you, rather it will affect your child. جزاكم الله خيرا سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك والحمد لله رب العالمين